My dear students, welcome back to my English literature class. I am Anjana Jindal and today I am back here with chapter number 1 of our English Mulberry book of class 4. And our chapter is Pippi Goes to the Circus. Children, now it's part 3 and in previous parts, that is part 1 and 2, I had explained you the meaning of the story and few exercises. And now in this video, I'm going to discuss the question answers and few more exercises for you. So children, now these are the question answers and this exercise is read, reflect and write. So here, question number 5, it is marked as question 5 in our book. So let's read the question first. Why did Pippi jump onto the horse? So children, why did Pippi jump? Obviously to have fun. Because Tommy told her, no, that circus is a fun. Yes. So she went there to enjoy, no? Yeah. Did she realize that she was doing something wrong? What do you think? So give a reason for your answer. So children, what do you think? Did she realize? No, of course not, because she was new to the life on land, no? She was not knowing about the ways of the life here, isn't it? She thought everything is for fun only. Yeah. So, our answer is, Pippi jumped onto the horse to have fun. No, she did not realize that she was doing something wrong because she was new to the life on land. Now let's see question number 6. If you were a friend of Pippi's and you had taken her to the circus, how would you have felt seeing her standing on the horse? So children, if you were Pippi's friend, so how would you have felt? So children, then if we see any of our friend enjoying, then obviously, we feel happy, no? Yeah, we feel happy and joyous, isn't it? Yeah, so the answer is, I would have felt happy and joyous to see her standing on the horse because she was enjoying over there, isn't it? Yes. Now, question number 7, why did the guards shrug their shoulders and walk away at the end of the story? So children, what do you think? Why did the guards shrug their shoulders? Yes, because they were unable to move Pippi from her seat, isn't it? They wanted to throw her out from the circus, no? But they were unable. Why? Because Pippi was a very strong girl. She was an extraordinary strong girl, isn't it? Yes. So our answer is, the guards shrugged their shoulders and walked away at the end of the story because they could not throw Pippi out from the circus. Now see, question number 8. In what way do you think is Pippi different from most children? And in what way do you think she is the same as most other children? So children, what do you think? That in what way Pippi was different from others? Means other children. Yeah, the way she lived her life. The way of living. Because she was not knowing about the life on land. It was the first time she was living on land, no? Yeah. So, she was different in that way. And how she was same? She was same as most other children. In the way, as she was also innocent, no? As children are innocent, so she was also innocent, no? She was not doing anything knowingly or intentionally. In the innocency only she was doing, no? Yes. So, our answer is, Pippi is different from most children in the way of living life on land. And she is the same as most other children in the way of being innocent. Okay, so these are the question answers, children, which you have to write very neatly in your mulberry copy. Okay. So children, our next exercise is word wall. Here in question number one, make sentences of your own with the following words from the story. So children, here few words are given and you have to make the sentences with your own. Okay. So first one is marvelous. Marvelous means extremely good, isn't it? Yes. So we can make a sentence in this way. Paris is a marvelous place to visit. Children, you can make other sentences as well. Okay. Next one, tightly. So I have formed a sentence. Rhea tightly hugged her father when she met him. Next word is shiny. So the sentence I have formed is, Priya got a shiny crystal inside the river. Next word is careless. So the sentence is, Rohit is careless regarding his studies. And the last word is thundering. And the sentence with the word thundering is, it was thundering all night, but there was no rain. So children, these are the sentences I have formed for you, but you can make other sentences as well, the sentences of your own. Okay. Children, next question, that is question two, is give one word for each. So children, here some clues are given to you and you have to give one word for each clue. Okay. So let's see. A part, the person who runs the show. Children, the person who runs the show, yeah, is called a ringmaster. Yes, ringmaster. Now B part, the circus tent, the big top, that is top. Now C part, a procession. A procession, what is it? It is parade. Yes, parade. Now D part, what the audience does after performance. So children, after the performance gets over, then what the audience does? Yes, they applaud, isn't it? Yes, so the one word for this clue is applaud. Now E part, an entertainer who performs gymnastic feats. So children, an entertainer who performs gymnastic feats is known as acrobat. Okay, acrobat. Now F part, an entertainer who performs by throwing and keeping several objects in the air at one time. So children, this performance is called juggling. Means throwing and keeping several objects in the air at a time, no? Yeah, that is called juggling. So the person who does this act is called a juggler. Yes, juggler. Now G part, a sweet treat. It's a candy. A sweet treat and a candy is cotton candy. The word is cotton, cotton candy. Okay. Now H part, a cycle with a single wheel. So children, a cycle with two wheels is called bicycle, isn't it? You must have, you all must have rode, no? Yes. And a cycle with three wheels is called? Yes, a tricycle. So, a cycle with a single wheel is called unicycle. Yes, unicycle. Now, I part. What performers do? So, children, what is the work of a performer? What performer do? Does? Yes, performers, entertainers, no? Yes, so what performers do? They entertain us. So, the word is entertain. Okay. Now, J part. A stretched rope on which acrobats perform. So, children, acrobats perform on a tight rope. That stretched rope on which acrobats perform is called a tightrope. Okay. So, children, now these were the exercises and the question answers. So, children, question answers you have to write very neatly in your mulberry copy. And the exercises you have to do in your book, in your mulberry book. You just fill there, but in a very neat and clean handwriting. Okay. Don't make your book dirty. Okay, children. So, children, I hope you all have understood the question answers and the exercises well, isn't it? Yes. So, now it's the time for your home assignment. Children, in your home assignment, you have to read the chapter again. Children, the number of times you will read the chapter, it will be more clear to you. Okay? And also your vocabulary will be increased. Your reading skills will be increased. Okay? So, read the chapter again. And do all the exercises in your mulberry book very neatly. And you have to do the question answers in your mulberry copy with a very neat and clean handwriting. Okay? So, few more exercises are left of this chapter, which we will discuss in our next video. Okay? So, bye-bye. Take care.